I love you, Henry.
I'm Henry Dawes.
I'm an associate of Mr. Ramil. Please, get in. Mr. Emile's very appreciative of you coming on such short notice. We do hope it wasn't too much of an inconvenience.
Oh, not at all. To be honest, I needed the work. It hasn't really been easy to come by.
Huh. Well, then I hope this is the first step toward reversing your fortune.
Yeah, me too. My wife and I were expecting a kid.
Congratulations, Mr. Dawes.
Thank you.
Is this your first?
Yes, it is.
Might I ask, boy or girl?
We actually don't know.
Ah, another surprise. How delightful. Don't worry, Mr. Dawes. This bridge has proven quite reliable. Out here can be scarce.
Great. My wife's gonna think I left for good.
I'm sure she'll understand.
I don't think so.
Ah. Well, here we are.
Beautiful structure, isn't it?
Late 18th century?
Precisely. Word to the wise, Mr. Dawes, Mr. Emile can be a rather demanding soul. But just do as he asks, and I promise you, the compensation can be quite generous.
Let me give you a little something.
No need for gratuity, Mr. Dawes. It's all been taken care of.
Well, thank you. When can we expect you back?
Well, that is entirely up to you, Mr. Dawes. Yes. Have a good stay.
May I help you?
I'm Henry Dawes, here to appraise the estate.
Mr. Ramil has put you in the north end of the house, overlooking the pond. Once you've settled, you're to join him for a nightcap in the library. This will be your room. You'll find the bathroom at the
far end of the hall.
Looks wonderful, thank you.
Believed that Bach died from complications of eye surgery. An infection festered when a traveling oculist attempted to remove cataracts from his eyes. The procedure failed mightily, and within 4 months, Bach was dead. The greatest composer the world has ever known chose to fight his blind fate rather than accept it. Pride was his undoing.
I'm not proud, but I am happy. And happiness blinds, I think, more than pride.
Alexander Dumas.
The Count of Monte Cristo. My wife made me read it.
Smart woman.
You have no idea.
Mr. Dawes, I presume.
Please. Call me Henry.
Come, Henry. Join me by the fire. I hope your journey wasn't too uncomfortable.
Oh, no, not at all.
Would you care to join me for an evening spirit?
Yes, I would love to.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Gates. Cheers.
Cheers. Got a beautiful home here.
Thank you. Sadly, I'm the last of a dying breed. I fear once I'm gone, the estate will follow suit.
No family?
My late wife was unable to bear children. Adoption was always a conversation rather than a reality.
I apologize if I'm overstepping my bounds, but without a beneficiary, why bother with the appraisal?
Curiosity, I suppose. Even I don't know everything about this place. Then again, maybe I just wanted the company.
Well, then, to paid company.
To you, Henry. My old body is begging for some rest. Feel free to look around the place if you like. I'll see you in the morning for breakfast. Good night, Henry.
Good night.
Thank you.
I suggest you wait till morning.
Of course.
Good evening, Mr. Dawes.
Back there, about 300 yards, my mother built herself a little home away from home. We lovingly referred to it as her madhouse. Small cottage where she could cool the daily agitations that my father presented her. You see, my father was a drinker. My mother was a Methodist.
Well, my parents divorced when I was 15. Maybe your mother was onto something.
Maybe she was. Maybe she was. The house has been vacant for over 2 decades. Due to my decline in health, I haven't seen it in nearly that long. Would you mind taking a few pictures to share with me at dinner tonight?
Whatever you need.
Thank you. Holler if you need anything.
Thank you. Holy shit!
Sad to say, he is not the first that we've dealt with over the years. Transients, drifters, even fugitives have sought asylum in our woods. Property this large lends itself to stowaways. Did you find anything else on the body? Any sort of identification?
No, I didn't look. I mean, legally, I shouldn't have even touched the note.
What a sin. To give up on life so easily.
Well, we should call the police.
I'll take care of that, Mr. Dolls. I'll see that the body is properly disposed of.
Disposed of?
Poor choice of words. A proper burial, of course. I do hope you'll stay and finish the appraisal. I'm prepared to offer you greater pay to compensate for today's unpleasantries.
I don't think that would be appropriate.
$5,000 on top of your fee.
That's a sizable offer.
$7,000.
Mr. Emil, I think you should find someone else.
Tell me, Mr. Dolls, just what would your departure accomplish, hmm? An ethical victory? A moral triumph? Because it certainly won't help to take care of your wife or your unborn child.
How do you know about my family?
My driver and I. We spoke. I understand this job is very important to you, Mr. Dawes.
Yeah, it is.
I am offering you a great deal of money. Enough to spoil your growing family. Please, don't allow a fool's poor judgment determine yours.
$10,000. On top of my fee.
We have a deal. I do hope you enjoy lamb.
So the Meadows definitely has some interesting stuff, like that, for example.
Yeah. We named him Henry, coincidentally. He was a gift to my mother. Brought back from China nearly 60 years ago.
Well, that's quite a gift.
My family has never been one for the obvious, Mr. Dawes.
Take a look. Oh,
that is beautiful. You have quite an eye.
I've had a lot of practice.
In what way?
I used to be a photographer.
Professionally?
Yep, for a number of years. I have my own studio.
this broken down warehouse. I mean, we had brown water and the occasional rat, but loved everything about that place.
What changed?
That's a long story.
I have all the time in the world.
One day, this drop-dead brunette walked through my doors. She had these little cut-off shorts, porcelain skin. Honestly, she was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. She asked me if I took headshots. She wanted to be an actress out in Hollywood. I'd never taken a headshot in my life, but I lied right to her face and said with a smile, "Of course I do." Tragically enough, that young lady never did make it to Hollywood.
Oh?
Because I married her 3 months later. About a year after the marriage, my business was failing. The market was diluted. My father-in-law threw me a line. He offered me this gig. Steady pay, good benefits. And we wanted to start a family, so I couldn't afford to say no. Closed the studio, sold all my equipment, and that's that.
How easily we betray the things we love. That's enough reminiscing for one night. Try to get some rest, Mr. Dawes. I have something special to show you in the morning.
Looking forward to it.
Have a good night, Henry.
You too.
morning.
Coffee.
Nice big tray for a little cup. Thank
you. May I get you anything else?
No, ma'am.
Something on your mind?
You got any horses in that stable?
Not for many years. I never took much to them. And in return, they never took much to me. Shall we?
This farm has been in our family for generations. Centuries of history under our very feet. At one time, the main house was an inn, a bed and breakfast of sorts for travelers heading north into the mountains. Many nights I've imagined all the souls that must have passed through here, each with their own story to tell. Ah, here we are. Tell me that their beauty isn't absolutely undeniable.
These are incredible.
Each and every piece machined from scratch. 10,000 hours to create.
Did you build these?
Oh, no. I am not nearly patient enough. It was my father who made them.
Amazing. Do they still run?
Of course. Though I wouldn't dare venture them out on that old track out there. I can't help but feel that the majority of people take the world's beauty for granted. The time spent incepting, designing, creating all that is. These objects in space. Needless to say, I feel it is my God-fearing responsibility to preserve that beauty. And, when need be, give it a little polish from time to time.
These are works of art, Mr. Emil. There's no question about it. But I'll be honest, when it comes to their worth, I don't even know where I'd start.
That's easy, Henry. They're priceless. Through there, you'll find the staircase on your left leading to the storage garage. Between that and the machine shop, you should find plenty of work to fill your day.
was that?
You need to calm down, mister.
Don't you tell me to calm down. Do you see that? I was attacked on your property, understand?
Are you threatening me?
I need to know what's going on right now.
You're in shock, Henry. You have suffered a sharp blow to your head, and I suspect a victim to a concussion.
You didn't answer me.
Take a moment, Mr. Dawes. Calm your nerves. And when you have done so, meet me in the kitchen for a civilized conversation. In the meantime, I shall fetch Mrs. Gates to tend to your wound. You have taken liberties with my hospitality, Mr. Dawes.
There is something in that barn.
A real thin creature, ravaging an unlucky hen. Is that correct?
You saw what was left of that bird.
What I saw was the rotten remains of an escaped farm animal. Nothing more.
I'm telling you the truth.
See it through my eyes. I find you in the stable, alone, your head bleeding and your camera smashed. An empty glass of bourbon on the porch. Can you at least appreciate my perspective?
I understand how it must look.
What's really troubling you, Mr. Dawes? It's in your eyes. Something deeper. Something personal.
I'm just trying to do my job, and that's it.
You are here to perform a service, Henry. One that means a great deal to me. Can I count on you?
Yeah.
Good. I had faith you'd muster the will. Besides, I am growing quite fond of your company. Get a good night's rest. I'll see you in the morning.
Thank you.
I'm not doing this.
I'm not sure I know what you mean.
You're telling me you don't feel something evil. Nothing.
I was raised in a house of refuge, Mr. Dawes. A reformed school for teenage girls. By societal standards, we were classified as undesirable. To the sexual appetites of deep-pocketed men, we were quite the opposite. And when we matured and lost our childlike appeal, we became something else. Disposable. To answer your question, Mr. Dawes, I have felt evil many times. Never in this place.
Hello? Mr. Ramil?
You overslept, Mr. Dawes.
I wasn't feeling well, I'm sorry.
Are you leaving us?
My wife needs me home.
Is that all?
I need to be home.
I thought we had a deal, Mr. Dawes.
Well, you can keep the money.
Let us amend our agreement. I detest ending on poor terms. It is clear that you are headstrong in your decision, but my driver will not be available until morning. So here is my compromise. If you will work through the night to make up for your daytime repose, I will see that you are fully compensated.
I appreciate the offer, Mr. Emil, I really do. But I can't finish this job in one night.
That's quite all right, Mr. Dawes. There will always be others.
One more night, full pay, and I leave at dawn.
That's fine, Mr. Dawes. You find the barn a quarter mile south of the main house, just past an old fishing boat.
Hello?
It's hers, not mine. I promise I'll be good.
Hello? I'm Henry. What's your name? Why are you praying? Is someone out there?
Stop!
No. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. Will you take that off? Please? I just want to talk to you. Can I take it off?
did that to you?
We need to get you out of here. Gotta get you some help. Hey, where'd you go? Hey!
Ah, you've awakened. Whoa. Okay, my friend.
Who the hell are you?
My name is Amar. I found you unconscious near the woods. I hope you don't mind. I took the liberty of cleaning your wounds.
How'd you get out here?
I may ask you the same question, my friend.
You're a fugitive.
I thought I had escaped, but I'm far from free.
What did you do?
I took what is not mine. I'll bring you no harm. Please, sit. Are you hungry? Take it easy, my friend. The meat is rich. You'll make yourself ill if you eat too quick.
Thank you for this.
The pleasure is mine. I must confess, I haven't shared a meal in many days. And I fear the solitude breeds madness.
Well, I suspect if you were going to kill me, you wouldn't feed me first.
Well, that would depend on the degree of my madness.
From. You hear those?
How could I not?
I've been hearing things. I've been seeing all kinds of things that don't make sense.
I fear these things are quite real. They accompany my day and my nightmares as I sleep.
Yeah, what the hell are they?
I do not know, but the fire seems to keep them at a distance. In my religion, when you're very young, we are taught of the djinn. Are you familiar with this term?
Only the liquor.
I am Muslim. neither liquor. The jinn are dark beings created by Allah.
You're talking about demons.
Not demons, but not human either. They are depraved creatures caught between worlds, living in the shadows, forever wandering until their day of judgment.
Maybe you have been out here too long.
Well, that may be. But then I must ask you a question, my friend. Do you have a better theory? Stay close, my friend. As the darkness grows, so too does their impatience. I plan to move at first light. Will you join me?
Let's get the hell out of here.
Finally put, my friend. Until then, we keep the flames bright.
Yeah.
Doing?
Don't move! Please! Don't move!
What are you doing?
I know you. You've been here before.
I don't know what you're talking about.
They didn't follow you here. You led them to me. You're one of...
One of who?
The djinn.
That's in this...
They're here.
Thank you. goddamn it, I'm taking you with me. Come on!
Come on, get up!
Get out of here!
Come on!
Go alone, my friend. Now! Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.
Thank you.
found that body you disposed of! And Mrs. Gates! You son of a bitch! God damn it, Rimmel! You faced me!
Why am I here?
To appraise the estate, of course.
Bullshit.
You have a visitor, Mr. Dawes.
A visitor?
What is it about visitor that you don't understand?
Who?
See for yourself.
Becca? How did you get here?
Same way you did.
I don't understand. We need to leave, Rebecca. We have to go right now.
More Henry.
Oh, no.
Look at what happened.
in it from the beginning. And I tried to convince myself that you wouldn't do that to me. To us. To our baby girl. I held it all in. The pain and the heartbreak. I thought I'd been strong. But I wasn't strong enough for both of us.
What are you doing? Rebecca, put down the gun.
She died inside me, Henry. I was pregnant with our dead child while you were out there sleeping with that woman. That whore.
Rebecca, please.
I loved you.
I do love you. Ever since the first time I saw you, I've always loved you.
You brought her into our home, Henry. Into our bedroom. In our bed!
I know. It was a mistake. It was a horrible mistake. And I ended it.
It's over.
Yeah, it's over. Right, baby, just put down that gun. To get you to a hospital, okay?
Love is the true seed of every virtue in you. And for all acts for which you must atone.
Many nights I've imagined all the souls that must have passed through here, each with their own story to tell.
They are depraved creatures, caught between worlds, living in the shadows, forever wandering until the day of judgment.
But I can't finish this job in one night.
That's quite all right, Mr. Dawes. There will always be others.
Rebecca,
How did you get up here?
The same way you did. He's waiting for you.
So good of you to join me, Mr. Doll.
What is this place?
And so he created a place of purification, a land of provisional torment for those who are not yet worthy. A place where the glutton shall starve. Where the envious shall be blinded. Where the slothful shall never rest. Where the prideful shall serve. Where the greedy shall be chained. Where the wrathful shall mourn, and where the lustful shall burn. I'm proud of you, Mr. Dawes. You are doing far better than ever before.
What do you mean, before?
Don't you remember? You have failed many times.
So what are you?
Isn't that entirely clear? I am the overseer of this land and the guardian of the process. My role is quite simple. To purify.
What do I have to do?
The flames will judge the lustful soul. And if it proves worthy, the spirit will ascend.
And if not?
This is insane.
There is no alternative for repentance. The lustful soul must cross the flame.
I can't.
You must.
I won't leave her. Not again.
She is one of the sufferers. It is not yet her time.
Then I will wait. However long it takes.
This is your final opportunity for salvation. Deny it, and you will be damned. Come. Penitent.
Mr. O'Neill can be a rather demanding soul. Just do as he asks, and I promise you, compensation can be quite generous.
May I help you? Mr. Ramil has put you at the north end of the estate, overlooking the pond. Once you've settled, you're to join him for a nightcap in the library. Ma'am. Your room.